Georgia.info. My name is Eran Efrati and I'm the director of research in the American-Israeli Alliance. I'm a weapons researcher and Israeli military researcher in the exchange between Israel and the rest of the world in arms trade. When I grew up, I believed that we are the victim. Israel is the victim. It doesn't matter how you turn it. We are the victim and we have to defend ourselves before a second Holocaust will happen. What I realized throughout the military is that there are some people that want to think about it as a conflict. That's already better. But in fact, we're not defending ourselves from a second Holocaust, and it's not a conflict, it's an apartheid system of separation and control. I, as a soldier, control the life of thousands of Palestinians that was just trying to ask for very basic human rights, independence, equality to what I had at the time. Today, after knowing what I know and realize it's apartheid, I know that there's only one way to end this conflict, and that is to end the apartheid and give everybody equal rights. We believe that the entire economy of the state of Israel is based on the occupation. If we're talking about the approvals that Palestinians need to get to work for Israel, their forced work, their labor for us, for the state, their economy is our economy, really. They're a captive market. The occupation produced technology and methods of control that we later on sell the entire world, including Spain, like training your police officers or selling you weapons. We make a lot of money on the occupation. And the only way we believe to stop the occupation is pressure from outside and stopping all economical trade with Israel. They call for a non-violent, strategic, tactic way that worked in South Africa in the 80s in calling the rest of the world not to cooperate with the apartheid state of Israel. This is what we're asking, and this is the only simple, moral tactic and strategy that you in Europe can do. And if you will do that, Israel will understand that it cannot enable us to do it any longer, and we will have to stop the occupation. The moment the occupation will not be profitable anymore for the state of Israel, the occupation will end, and I believe it will happen. The BDS movement really called for all kind of boycotts, sanctions, and divestment from Israel. Economic is just one of them. But the cultural boycott, for example, is understanding that if the state, if Israel is sponsoring artists to come to Spain to perform here or to the Basque country to perform here, for example, they are not just coming as an artist. As an artist, they have a right to go all over the world and do whatever they want. But if they're representing the state of Israel, if they're receiving money from the state of Israel, they're becoming ambassador of a situation in which is this apartheid, in fact, on the ground. And in so, their art is really militarized for Israel. And that is something that the BDS movement is asking to boycott completely. You know, in Israel, we have a saying in Hebrew, it's not a country with a military, it's a military with a country. You know, in many ways, Israel is an occupying military that also have the state and the government. Any cooperation with any parts of the state is cooperating with the occupying military of Palestine. The apartheid was always the same. The set of laws was different, the same. You know, the military control was the same. Cruelty, separation of families, mass arrest, killing of thousands, administrative arrest, meaning without a judge or without a court, without knowing what you're accused of or seeing a lawyer or your family. That was always in place. Israel only had less than a year of not military control since 48 until today. In many other ways, it is getting worse. Every year that passes, the Israeli people are becoming more right-wing. Inside, internally, inside of Israel, they support more and more brutal ways to oppress the Palestinians. It seems like the answer from inside is getting farther and farther, and we rely on the outside world, we rely on our friends in the around the world to pressure us to stop what we're doing, because we're not going to stop it from inside. The cruelty that is going on in Palestine, in one way, was always the same, and in others, it is getting worse. More and more people dying, more and more areas are becoming less habitable, like Gaza. The water there is not drinkable, the air, the hospitals that are being bombed there every 2 years, and in fact, also between operations. These operations never end. The life in Palestine are terrible, but the hope is still high, and the resistance is still high. And the idea and the concept that if you and other people around the world will hear the cry, and we'll understand that this is the moment in history to stand on the right side and support Palestinians, it will end. and they will get independence. The alternative to the fascist right wing in Israel is not left, it's the generals, it's the military. It's either the white supremacist, Jewish supremacist, right wing Netanyahu government, or on the other side, the military. This is the two options in Israel, and it really doesn't matter who will be elected. The apartheid and the occupation will continue. The answer will not come from inside of the Israeli society or the Israeli election, an election where most Palestinians cannot vote for. I truly believe that the answer will come from outside, from economic, culturally, political pressure on the state of Israel, into the point that Israel will have to let go of their power because they understand that they're isolated in the world. And I do believe in a one democratic, secular state between the Jordan River and the sea where everybody are free, where everybody have the same right. I, as a Jewish Israeli, want that, not only because I support the Palestinian inspiration for freedom and equality, but because I don't want to live in an ethnocracy. I don't want to live in a religious state where my blood counts more than the blood of my friends in the occupied territories. I want to live in a one democratic state, and I believe it will happen in the near future. Okay.